Well, good Monday morning, everyone. Brand new week, isn't it? Are you ready? Well, I think I am. I think I am. And certainly here on Inspiration for Today, we have a week in store that I'm excited about, but I think it's going to be really valuable for us. Before I tell you what it is, let me ask you this question. Which part of the Word of God, the Bible, is the most important? Well, the answer to that, of course, is it's all important because it's all the Word of God and none of it is in there by accident. God planned it, it's perfect, and we need it all. We need it all. And so I find it interesting that many times we hear the same verses over and over again. And sermons are built on those verses. My devotions are built on those verses. And we repeat them. And part of that is because verses got into a group of verses that should be memorized. I know when I was a younger believer, I probably memorized, I'm going to say 150, 200 verses. And so I use those over and over and over again. Why? Because they're in my memory bank. And other pastors, other Christians do this. You'd probably do the same thing. You have a certain number of verses and those are the ones you remember. But they're all important in the Bible. So this week, we're going to look at five or six very important verses, but more obscure. I'm calling this obscure verses. And that's because we don't normally quote them, but that doesn't mean they're any less important. They are very, very important. So that's what we're going to do this week. And I'm looking forward to it because I'm going to memorize five new verses that I have not memorized in the past, but most of them are short, easily memorized, and it's going to be valuable for you and me to do so. Now, before I give you the verse for today, let me just ask you a question. And the verse for today will answer this question. What is the most valuable asset that you own? What's the most important thing that, or I don't care what adjective you put on it. What's your most prized possession? Well, when I think of that, I mean, I've had other things over the years, but, you know, my car, I really like my car. And it's expensive compared to anything else I have. It's not new, but it's still valuable. My house, if I get a little more spiritual, I could say, well, my wife. Most valuable thing I possess, but that's not a fair thing because no one possesses somebody else, but of something I treasure, that would be the top. But all those answers, and I don't know, what would you answer? Well, let me read you the verse for today. It comes from Psalm 36 at verse 7, and it says this, how priceless is your unfailing love, O Lord. O Lord, I mean, he's talking about the Lord's love. How priceless is your unfailing love. Well, that makes it the most expensive. It's priceless. It is priceless. And it really is, isn't it? Without God's love, we would have nothing. Now, why do we have God's love? The why is really an interesting question. Not only why do you have it, but why does mankind? Did mankind deserve God's love? And the answer, if you think it through logically, is no. Not at all. Mankind did not deserve, how could we deserve God's love when we did not exist prior to God creating us. If we didn't exist, how could we deserve anything? And yet, God, out of love, did create mankind. And then what did we as a race, human race, do? Very early on, we sinned. Oh my, isn't that something? In response to God's love, and of course, Adam and Eve were put in the perfect Garden of Eden, perfect place to live. By the way, similar in many ways to what we will experience in heaven after we go there, because heaven is without sin and the Garden of Eden was without sin. And so in many, many ways, similar. Now, even after we sin, God's overwhelming goodness, from which he created us, and then we immediately strayed, but God still loves us. I know we were talking about Adam and Eve, but if we bring it home to you and I, we still sin, didn't I? Yes, I do. And I did. And yet God gave his, brought out of God's love, then he sends his son, Jesus, to die on the cross that we just, and then to rise from the dead on Easter, which we just celebrated less than a month ago. And that was such an expression of that love. But the point I was really wanting us to take with us today is that we did not deserve it. And in fact, if we had earned it, if we had earned that love, it wouldn't be the same expression of love that God had for us. He showed it in that he sent his son for us. If we had earned it, he would just be rewarding us for what we earned with heaven. But that's not the case. So, having said all that, I'll just ask again, what's the most priceless thing, or the thing that is the most valuable in our life? And when we get asked that in the future, or at least I want to answer with Psalm 36:7. How priceless is your, Lord, unfailing love. Priceless, priceless. Wow. How do we respond to that, by the way? Well, we start to live for him. I mean, that's all we can do. We can say thank you, God, and we should in prayer. But we also live in light of that. That if a being, God, showed that kind of love for us in every way. Now, we talked about sending his son Jesus, but do you realize that everything we have that's good comes from him? God shows his love for us constantly, every day. We woke up today and we're breathing. And then we had a good breakfast, maybe. Everything good we have comes from the Lord, and it's an expression of his love for you and for me. Wow. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. That be our prayer today. We love you back. Hey, we're going to think deeply again tomorrow. See you then.